I hear the word fraction, my mind jumps straight to one thing, pizza. I often wonder, are pizza makers secretly fraction wizards? You might wonder, what makes a child like me excel in fractions or any other aspect of math? I believe it's all in the way it's been taught. Through my journey with math, I've encountered many magical and fun methods which have transformed my understanding of math. Let me take you through a few of them. First off, let's talk about learning through real-life experiences. I remember the time I had to share a large pizza with my sister and two cousins. There were 8 slices and 4 hungry mouths. I divided the number of slices by the number of people, and I quickly realized each person will get 2 slices each. Not only was the pizza a perfect circle, but the slices were isosceles triangles. So we practically got a lesson in geometry and fractions without even realizing it. Another innovative method my teacher introduced to us was using blocks. Imagine having different sized blocks, 1 large, 2 medium, and 3 small. The large block represented a whole, the medium ones halves, and the small ones thirds. This hands-on approach made abstract concepts tangible, showing us that 2 halves or 3 thirds indeed make a whole. Games too play a fantastic role in teaching math. Take Tears of the Kingdom, for instance, where shooting arrows at a specific trajectory becomes a thrilling math puzzle. Depending on the distance, you adjust your angle. Maybe 180 degrees for distant ones or 90 degrees for closer ones. Similarly, games like Angry Birds teach us about velocity and trajectory in the most entertaining ways. But why stop at fractions and geometry? Math is all around us, in the rhythm of music, structure of buildings, and even in the patterns of nature. By exploring these connections, we can learn complex concepts like algebra, probability, and more through the lenses of our everyday interests and hobbies. Speaking of probability, the world of statistics and probability opened up to me through the simple joy of playing board games and card games with my family. Understanding the likelihood of rolling a certain number on the dice or drawing a particular card on the deck made me realize that math predicts outcomes by extension in real-life scenarios. Through my journey with math, I've also found a deep fascination with the concept of time. For example, calculating how many hours I have left after school to do my homework, engage in my hobbies, and still get enough sleep sparked my interest in subtraction and multiplication. Exploring math in such diverse and appealing concepts has made me appreciate its beauty and utility. It's not just about getting the right answers, but about fostering a curious mind that tends to understand patterns, solve puzzles, and apply logical thinking in our everyday life. So I appeal to math teachers worldwide to seek for new methods to teach us math. Let's make math not just about memorizing formulas, but about learning the language of our universe. As the saying goes, if wishes were horses, beggars would ride. In my world, if wishes were fractions, pizzas would hide. But beyond the whimsy and the pizza, my real wish is for every child to see the magic in math that I see. Because when math makes sense, the possibilities are as infinite as the numbers itself. Thank you for joining me on this journey of math. Let's keep exploring, questioning, and discovering the joy of learning together.